Welcome out to North California. Population, 200,000. It's a city with a very diverse culture. The popular local catchphrase is going hard in the nard. This may be attributed to Oxnard's above average crime rate. Every crime has a victim, and every victim has a story of strength, struggle, and love. This is the tale of Oliver Barnes, and it begins with Oliver, stoned.
Interior of the actor is soaked.
No, that's part of the dangerous package.
Don't bullshit me, dog. I know you were not joyriding in this car. You took this to the hands-free off Victoria, didn't you?
Yeah. If I pay for it, so who cares?
Are you high?
No.
Then why are your eyes so red?
Well, the shampoo. Shot in my face.
You see the space between my fingers? That space represents how close you are to being fired. That's no sizzle, my man.
I'm so sorry you had to see that.
Speeding up the process by getting the car washed first. I didn't know Miss Jones let the sunroof open. I can't be blamed for that.
Oh, of course, you can't be blamed for that. You can't be blamed for anything. That's the magic of Oliver. Never responsible for his actions.
Who takes a car to get washed with the windows down?
All right, fine. I'll do better. Why don't you put me on the phones?
Forget it. You'll be calling for pizzas, checking the correct time.
Here, you know what?
Hit the streets.
Dad, why am I on flyer duty?
You need to start taking advantage of the opportunities that you're given. Because if you don't, mark my words, they will disappear. Oh, and Oliver?
Yeah?
Could you please call me Jeff?
The whole dad thing makes me out to be kind of old and weird, you know? Because we're the dangerously cool dudes.
Hey? Is this broke? Did you sit in my chair?
Come on down to Dangerous Details, where the danger is in the details. First visit's free.
Oh, excuse me, miss.
Hi, not a second.
Are you sure? I'm really detail-oriented. I'll do a good job.
Fine. I'll take one. But only because my boyfriend drives a really bitchin' car.
Yeah, we don't really do free details with your boyfriend.
Pussy!
Come on, man! Shit.
The devil. What? The devil is in the details. You got your whole slogan, ass backwards. Just have some pride in your marketing.
Yeah, well, it's not my slogan. It's my dad's. It's his company.
What you got there, Chief?
Marijuana? Well, you probably shouldn't partake, seeing as how you're working and all.
Yeah, well, YOLO or something, right?
I love YOLO. How is he?
He's good.
Would you say hello for me?
Sure, man. Whatever you say, bud.
You know what? I see a lot of myself in you. The way you carry yourself.
Oh, yeah? How so?
Well, I don't normally like to dispense advice here on the bench. It's not safe. But if you want to come back with me to my tent, I could probably teach you a thing or two about life.
Yeah, screw that. I got dreams to follow.
I have dreams. Had. But life is good.
Yeah. Hello. Louise? Why do you have a ladder?
Oh, you guys, look here! It's really hard to paint, like all his lines, like really straight and stuff. I always wonder if it's like a paintbrush or what you do with that. What's India like? Is it spicy?
Oh, you guys forgot your paint.
Romantic, really? Hey, that's my joint.
She wears skinny jeans. My father wears skinny jeans. We, nothing. You don't think that's kind of strange, right?
Are you guys going out back? Oh, holy shit, my skate ball. I'm okay.
Yo, Benson, I have an emergency.
My favorite drug dealer.
Weed dealer. What's up with those guys?
Oh, those are my new Indian friends. I really haven't broken through the language barrier yet, so I'm just calling them Dagger and Bloodline. Hey, do you have any more of that platinum blue dream I love?
Oh, sorry, all out.
Seriously? You're kidding me, right? Do I ever lie? Did you ever cry during Requiem for a Dream?
No.
Why did your dad leave your mom?
She left him, I blame myself.
Was there ever a time in your life when you thought you were gay?
Not fully, but I had a few sense of bi curiosity in high school.
How big is your penis?
3.5 inches.
What? So much action.
It's not the size of the dog, it's how you walk it.
Wow. It's been a very revealing morning. Come on in.
Thank you. Thank you. Why are you off work? This is the strangest thing. Jeff just gave me the day off.
Come on, man. You're not telling me you're afraid to wake up one day all old and alone, wishing you had family and kids and babies to kick it with?
Hell no. I am not a commitment guy. I swim solo, like a shark.
Yeah, doesn't sound like a shark to me. Bet you got some secrets hidden away.
The truth is out there, man. Hey! I live a life of transparency to set an example. An example for how the human race should treat one another. Yeah, I am leading a movement to truth. You should join us. I'm serious. I bet the government... You know what the government is keeping record of all this stuff you're doing on the internet? I bet that the NSA has more info on you than the Stasi had on the East Germans.
Oh, hey, Jennifer, what's up?
What's up? Fuck you. That's what's up. How many times have I told you to not smoke pot with these Mexican painters?
They're totally Indian. How are you even confusing those two?
We are paying them by the hour. You are literally costing me money right now. Yeah, that's right. Enchilada tikka masalas. Let's go. Let's get out of here. Come on. Back to work.
You know, when you pay people an hourly rate, they tend to take their time, especially when you treat them like shit.
Then maybe your lazy ass should have gotten up and actually done something around here, like, oh, I don't know, painted the house?
Oh, not have a dick showing contest. I bet you spent all day at the clubhouse pool, am I right?
Fuck you, Olive. I had errands to run for Jeff.
Oh, in a bathing suit? Now, face it, you do less than I do.
Oh, I seriously doubt that. I'm the head of marketing and the official spokesmodel. At Dangerous Details, we whip through the competition. We pick up, detail, and deliver your vehicle at top speeds for lightning cheap prices.
Call us today to get your first detail free.
Come on down to Dangerous Detail, where danger is in the detail.
Bitch, please, don't act like you run this place. You only slept with my dad for his money. We all know you had sex with Benson senior year for some coke.
It's true, those were some dark days.
Oliver! Better not have bailed out of work to sit on that couch and smoke weed with your loser friend Benson.
Hey, look at that bang bag, mommy.
It's so fresh, because I'm going to take you to lunch, girl. All the way to lunch.
Okay, fine, but I'm picking.
Why don't I ever get to pick?
Hey, I better take some food.
Oh, Benson. What's up, bro?
Oh, exploded.
Can I get Oliver alone for a minute outside?
Sure, whatever.
What do we do next? Is it bad blood? Alaskan Thunderfuck. Winner!
Look, Oliver, I've been talking to Jennifer. I mean, this arrangement's not working.
clever arrangement.
You? What? The house? You're not taking any of it serious. It's time for you to go stay with your mother. That's a moment. Wouldn't that be nice?
Look back! Tucson's a hellhole. I had one bad day. I slipped up. I can get back on my feet.
We've had several bad days. And you know what? I don't see you doing anything to fix it.
Well, I've been living the dream, you know? I'm doing so many things I can't even keep count. It's not my fault. The economy. You know, outsourcing. Everything's going robotic now. You know, social networking has literally changed the game.
All right, enough excuses. I need you to get all your stuff together so you can be out by the end of next week.
Please, Dad. I mean, please, Jeff, don't send me to Tucson. I know I fucked up the flyers, and I know I fucked up that MILF's car, but I can do better. Just give me one more shot to show my value. We're the dangerously cool guys, right? You fucked up the flyers? How could you fuck up the flyers? You just had to hand them out.
Okay, get up. Come on, get up. Enough with the theatrics. Stop being such a pussy, bro. Now, Mrs. Rhodes called about her sweet frickin' Mercury, okay? She wants the full dangerous package.
The answer is yes. Anything but Tucson.
I don't want to see you at all this weekend. You got it? Jennifer and I need a little alone time. We haven't been physical in a while, so I need you to hook a brother up, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Is that a deal?
Like the best. This is probably, I would say this is probably top five best weed I've ever smoked.
Oh, thanks. Hey, that reminds me. Your dad's a dick. Jennifer's a racist. That shit hurt my feelings, okay?
Yeah, well, I don't think they really understand your profession.
Or you, for that matter. You're a complicated guy.
What's that complicated?
They don't have to make fun of me. That's what I'm saying.
I'm sorry, man. I'm walking on eggshells with that dude. You want this?
Nah, thanks. I'm good. Unless you really need more than I do, anyway.
All right, dude.
Made him. Yeah, outside handle.
Oliver, my sweet thank you for coming on such short notice.
Oh, not a problem, ma'am. My job after all. You know what I mean.
I sure do. Well, here's the car.
Whoa, this thing is super sweet. What's the need for the dangerous detail?
Well, if you must know, I had a small fling with a hot young ticket and we sprayed love juice on the back seat. I wish he were as masculine as you, sweet thing.
That is pretty disgusting. But I'll see what I can do. When do you need it by?
Monday. My husband's coming back, and he will flip his lid if he finds another man's DNA on the back seat, if you know what I mean.
I do. You've made that quite clear.
Oh, Oliver, you are such a sweet boy.
Say, do you think I could get $50 up front? I'm gonna need to get some special leather scrub for that interior.
I'm looking for a girl to twerk with me. I love ice cream.
Shut the fuck up. I'm working today, and this is supposed to be my day off. Oh, that's my fault? You know, you can find your own damn ride to the party, because I'm done doing your shit.
Yo, what's this dude's deal? Is he selling ice cream or what?
Yo, what up, homie?
Man, this dude's hella pissed. He's been screaming at his phone for 20 minutes.
You piece of shit. You know what? I'm done buying your face makeup, okay? So fuck you, Dad.
You dickheads want? Yeah, hi. I know this might be a strange request, but do you have any beef sticks or Slim Jims?
This is an ice cream truck, not a meat wagon.
Look, baby D, just bust out four of them Choco Tacos. Me and the homie got the munchies like a motherfucker right now.
All right, I got three, so $6.
Can you get mine down? I'll hit you back next paycheck.
Sure.
Can you break a 50?
What the fuck does this look like? Wamu? No, I can't take a 50. Go get some change.
Can I get change for 50?
Are you buying anything here?
Yo, you little punk ass. That liquor store has the same ice cream prep.
Guy too. You know it only takes 32 seconds to jimmy the lock on the Mercury and another 15 to get it started? Over 100 cars are stolen every week, most of which are never returned to their owners. Ah. talk to my friend Benson.
Do you have a last name, sir?
He never told me. Could you rattle off a few options?
I'm not sure I'm allowed to say.
Fuck! I'm fucking high. What's the number for the cops?
That would be 911, sir.
Can you describe the vehicle?
It was a 55 Mercury. You know the model? I'm not a fucking engineer. Hey, language. It was a vintage car and had love stains in the back seat. I mean, how many of those old Mercuries are driving around?
You don't look like the type of guy who'd be driving a classic car. You look more like a bike guy. You sure not missing a bike?
What? No, fuck you. Hey, language. I wasn't riding a bike. I never learned how.
It's like I had an incomplete childhood. Are you high?
No. I've just been crying over this stupid car.
Uh-huh. What's that in your pocket?
It's nothing. It's a tumor.
Here, hold this one, will you?
Wait,
you're still on fire! Oh, my, my, my. Look what we have here.
That's not mine.
Oh, purple. You used to smoke dope like this back in the 80s.
Oh, man, I worked hard for that.
Get the fuck out of here.
Wait, but what about the car?
We probably won't find it. If you hear anything, we'll give you a call.
Can I get a ride?
Everyone.
Do you take the car I was driving?
Oh, man. You got a car? Boy, you should give me a ride in the skate park.
No! What? My car was stolen. Did you see who took it?
No, I don't know. I don't really pay attention to things.
Damn it!
Hey, you seem upset.
I am. I'm fucking pissed. My high is wearing off.
Oh, you smoke? That's cool. Hey, you want to go burn a bowl?
Oh my goodness, I would love to. Right on, brother.
So, you got some good shit?
I don't have any shit. I don't have any shit. You're the one who... You at...
Okay, my bad, bro. That was a communicable misunderstanding. But dude, you should get back at that fool for taking your weed. Take his ice cream.
You should have steal the whole fucking truck.
Oh, there you go, big dog. Now that is a motherfucking come-up. He steals your weed, and you steal his ride. Pay it forward.
Dumbass. You didn't even get a choco. Take two.
Treason. Those of you just tuning in, our weekend topic is the Anunnaki, a shape-shifting race of reptilian humanoids hiding in plain sight as our world leaders. Are they real? Let's go to Mark Calloway from Fort Worth, Texas.
I believe that these dinosaurs are living underground and using the Earth's core as their heat source like a second sun.
Well,
Vincent, it's Oliver. I'm freaking out. I need you.
Mark Calloway from Texas. I'm going to call you back.
Built a military base on the dark side of the moon if you plug my...
Sorry. Machine treason. Protecting mankind from the man. We will return shortly.
Oh, man, it's just me. Let me in.
Okay, aside from terrorizing my podcast, what the hell are you doing in my house? This isn't a pickup service. Deliveries only.
What to do with those girls?
They're my employees. I had to hire some trusted help for, you know, my crops.
Why aren't they wearing any clothes?
They couldn't trust them. It's like New Jack City in here. Just get inside. You're baked out of your mind. Your car gets jacked. You call the 5-0. A cop beats your ass. And then you just think, hey,
I'm gonna steal this ice cream truck.
It's like you're always saying, man. This is some conspiracy theory shit. What if it was Jennifer? What if she set me up?
No! On your show!
All right, I seriously doubt it was Jennifer, okay? Hold on, are you sure you weren't followed? I mean, the police know that you're short on herbage. What if this is like some kind of sting operation?
No, no, relax. I wasn't followed.
That was a fucking cop knock, man.
You know, because it was five solid fist knocks, man. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Shit.
Do you hate me right now?
Yes! Okay, just... All right, everybody act natural. I need to find some kind of disguise. Who are you?
Are you the driver of the ice cream truck?
No, who wants to know?
Me, Megan, the driver of that scooter over there.
Shit.
Yeah, I'm already late to work and that's my only mode of transportation.
Oliver! Come on inside. Twyla, Megan, Twyla.
Did you destroy my scooter?
Yeah, I did. Are you okay?
No, I'm not okay. You ran over my scooter with your ice cream truck. How am I supposed to feel?
Yeah, I'm having a really shitty day, too. I was supposed to fix this milf's car.
Yeah, I don't care about your problems. I just need a ride to work.
Well, like I said, I got a lot going on right now, you know, so I've got this tax return thing, I got to file, and it's already May, and I got to do karate, so
okay,
I got stuff.
Fine, we'll just file a police report then.
Oh, okay. It's cool your jet, lady. Oliver, can I speak to you alone for a second? Okay, this is exactly the opportunity you were looking for, okay? It's time to step up to the plate. There's a girl out there, she needs your help. You could be her JFK.
I know, she's nice, but now's the worst time than ever to think about starting a family. I mean, look at the Middle East, and public schools, and the economy. I can't take her to Tucson.
The fuck are you talking about? You're starting a family, you're taking her to work. You destroyed the only mode of transportation. Mm-hmm. It's the least you can do. As a bonus, maybe you could nab her number. Eh?
I can do that.
You can do that. Meg.
Megan.
Right. I'm Oliver. So do you live around here?
Yeah. I live at the same apartment complex as your friend.
Oh, that explains the moped being parked there, huh?
It's a scooter.
Right. So, what do you do for work?
I'm a barista at Paul's Coffee.
Oh, that sounds awesome.
It's not. And I've already missed most of my shifts, so if you could hurry out, that'd be really great.
Oh, okay, got it. Right. Lock it up, pedal the metal.
Right there.
Okay. Make it a little wide. It's gotta be a wide turn. But, what's right in there?
It's nothing.
It's like a lot of words.
It's just something I'm working on. I don't think you'd understand.
Oh, yeah? Try me.
Veronica Mars fan fiction.
Oh, yeah. I know, that's a detective show with the girl from Brea, Sarah Marshall. What's it about?
Well, in this one, Veronica teams up with the PCHers, and they uncover a murder mystery, and she falls in love with evil. It's silly, but I like it.
I can stand behind silly.
So I just call you about my scooter?
Yeah. Funny story about that. Maybe I should just get your number. I'm kind of in a rough situation. I lost my phone earlier today, so... Again, I'm really sorry, and I promise I will make it up to you.
Just don't screw me, okay?
I'll try not to.
You know
what, Freddy? Late.
That's what
I'm Justice. Think twice before you yell at my friend Megan here. Gah! It's my turn.
She's a hard worker. She's early every day and she stays late every night. She's your fucking anchor.
You need to watch it. We've got families here.
You know we had the highest sales of the year last month? Are you going to ignore that? Are you going to ignore the quarterly reports? You know what? If you fire her, you're going to have to fire me too.
I am so sorry. I really thought that was going to work.
If it's any help, I'm pretty sure I'm getting fired on Monday.
How would that be any help? I don't know how I'm going to pay my rent. I don't know how you're going to fix my scooter. I'm scared.
Yo, mini dude. What can I do for you?
Are you open for business?
Oh, I'm not really an ice cream vendor. Sorry.
That's a bit misleading. You're sitting outside of an ice cream truck. Why aren't you guys selling?
Yeah. Why aren't we selling? So, 5 more days like this, and we should be able to repair my scooter. Now, you'll be a good ice cream salesman. Do you need an assistant?
I would love an assistant. If this was my real job, but it's not. I was supposed to detail a car today, and it got stolen, and I was, like, panicking, and I freaked out, so I stole this truck. But I'm pretty sure the person who stole my car was the same guy driving this truck. Does that make sense?
So, you're a screw-up and a thief.
Yeah, just, like, a little bit, though.
Okay. Why don't we team up anyway? We can sell some ice cream, and I'll help you find a car.
I mean, you don't have to do that. I can just drop you off at your house.
Oh, no. Honestly, that's the last place I want to be right now. Plus, I've seen every episode of Veronica Mars, so I'm pretty well prepared.
Okay.
So you said the guy that stole your car was driving this ice cream truck?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Well, why don't we go to his house and pay him a little visit?
Okay, well, that's fine and dandy, but how do you know where he lives? This house matches the ice cream truck pretty well.
Yeah, I think we found a fit.
Devin!
Hi, yes, sorry. We're looking for Devin. Have you seen him?
I haven't seen him. It's 16 years.
Are you blind?
Ooh, smart lady.
Hey, you want to come inside? Have a nice sexually active imagination. You both come inside.
Yeah, I don't think we're going to do that. Can you just tell us where Devin is, please?
I'm not telling you anything unless you do something for me.
All right. What do you want from us?
Oh, God, I don't want anything from you, boy.
Just a girl.
Okay.
I would say
that
just because
you're
dating. No! Boy, come on, what's the issue?
God, it's perfect. I gotta get wood already. Good. Yeah. Okay, strong. Oh yeah, you work out. I can feel it.
Yeah, I do the elliptical twice a week.
Oh, that's wonderful. You're fuzzy. Oh God, you're like a freaking bottle. Like beep beep.
Ah, okay, that's enough. Just tell us where Devin is, please.
Oh God, he's where he always is, hanging out at the freaking skate park.
Okay, we're gonna go. Thank you.
Well, that guy was pretty freaking creepy. You think we should leave him in the truck?
Heck no, we're having an adventure. Besides, he's blind. He won't know we have it anyway.
Back in five.
Okay, so what does this guy look like?
Kind of young. He's angry.
He used to sell ice cream.
Maybe something more visual.
Right. Well, I think I know this one. Yo, Choco Taco. Nice boy slime, my man.
What's up, homie? Hey, you think you can give me a ride to Subway real quick? Let's pick up a foot-long roast beef?
No, what is wrong with you? Have you seen that Devin kid that was driving the ice cream truck?
Oh, shit, maybe they fed him. And he's right over there, dog. Yo, Devin! Bring that micro cock over here.
Liz,
my homies want to talk to you.
It's good. Did you steal my car?
No.
What?
Is your dad a blind clown?
He's a face-painting alcoholic, and he's two steps away from a home, yeah, but he's definitely not blind.
No, you're lucky I didn't call the cops on you for stealing my ice cream truck.
Yeah, why didn't anybody call the cops?
Well, I know somebody called the fucking cops. I seen him.
Yeah, you know, everybody better leave me alone before I flip the fuck out.
All right, calm down there, little whippersnapper. You want to smoke out?
Ah, shit, homie, that sounds Taco Bell.
Well, naturally, I assumed the angry kid driving the ice cream truck was the same dude who stole my car.
That makes sense.
That shit adds up.
How does that shit add up?
Well, we got the truck. Maybe you guys got some key intel and you want to make a trade?
Dude, no deal, man. That fucking truck has ruined every summer vacation I've had since I was 16 years old. Honestly, getting it stolen was the best thing that ever happened to me. All I do now, man, is skate all day, smoke weed, slay hot chicks.
One chick, two dicks.
Yeah. Right here in this bowl, actually.
Guys, at the crime scene, did you see anyone who looked suspicious?
Well, there was this one big guy. I mean, he was pretty big, like Randy Orton big, not like the Big Show.
Oh, yeah, that fool was huge. He had a mohawk.
But yeah, dude, he had braids, too. He was bad as hell.
Crazy.
Wait, he had a mohawk and braids?
No, what was the thing he had on his neck? It was like a tattoo or something, you know, like pyramids or Egypt or some shit.
Nah, man, it was the all-seeing eye.
Yeah, dude, it was the all-seeing eye.
Oh. You know this?
Yeah, just like that.
Just like that, girl?
We have a clue.
You have a lead.
Now what?
Let's go see your friend Vincent. He seemed like a popular type.
Yo, wait. Let me get one of those Flintstone push-ups before you dip.
All right, come on.
All right, here we go. There you go. Enjoy it. Stay in school, okay?
I'm not ready for school yet.
Not yet? When do you start?
I don't know.
Oh, all right. Well, I'll see you later. Hey, Megan.
Yeah?
I just want to say thank you for everything. I mean, if it wasn't for you, I'd probably be packing for a one-way trip to the second worst place on Earth.
Where's the second worst place on Earth?
Tucson, Arizona.
Hmm. Where's the first worst place on Earth?
That blind clown's house.
Well, if it were up to me, you would get to stay here. We have yet to find the car.
Yeah, but it almost feels possible now.
Thank you.
We have that now.
You're high.
Yeah.
Mark from Texas, I'm really sorry they gotta put you on hold again.
But by the way, we're just getting another plan for world domination.
I know, I'm sorry, I'm really
what
sorry.
Is
come on, it's me, Oliver.
Hey, Megan!
Oh, you're supposed to come here anymore, and why aren't you at work?
I'm so sorry to come in unannounced, but we have some really good information.
Great information. We need you to take a look at it.
Tell me what you think.
I don't know what I'm looking at. It looks like a Native American Mr. T. Are you expecting somebody?
No.
Who would we call here this late?
It's your drug dealer?
Weed dealer. I only do deliveries.
What's this bad?
What? Who is it? NSA? CIA? FBI?
Ex-boyfriend.
You have an ex-boyfriend?
Yeah. It's a long story.
And she's kind of allowed.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I think we should have a conversation about that. What? Hey, I want to have a conversation in the grown room, okay? Get out of here. You better be a cop. Yes.
What up, Chief?
Nice place.
Thanks. What's that smell? You got a pet skunk or something?
No. What do you want?
I'm looking for my girlfriend, Megan. That's her scooter spread out on the lawn. A yay big
little blonde girl. I mean, totally fake blonde, but still hot.
Little squirrely. Seen her?
Yeah, I've seen her.
Did you see her today?
Yeah, I saw her today.
What the hell is your deal, hippie? You stoned right now?
No, actually, I don't smoke before I do my podcast. Paranoia gets to me. You should check it out, actually. It's machinetreason.com.
Fuck your podcast, bro.
Okay.
Looking for Megan. You seen her or what?
She was here, but then she left.
Okay. Where did she go?
She went to work.
No, I went by her work. She wasn't there.
She came back.
So she's here?
A person may or may not be within this facility.
What the hell are you saying to me right now?
Are you fucking with me?
No, I'm not. Really not. I want to ask you one last time. Where is my girlfriend?
She's in Time of Avarium. It's a room full of aquariums. I have turtles and snakes. It also doubles as my cannabis grow room. She's in there with an unmotivated stoner that may or may not be having sex with her. I'm not really sure about that just yet. There's also two half-naked women who I have not yet had sex with, but I've been feeling the tension build for a number of days now.
You don't have to be a dickhole, bro. Okay? A simple she's not here would have sufficed. You know what the problem with this country is right now, bro?
I do a whole podcast on that.
Dickhole stoners like you. The hippies lost. Drink it in, suck it up, and build some credit while you're at it. All right? Loser?
I'll work on that.
Yeah, fuck your mother.
Man, screw that bro bag. Oh, no offense.
That's okay. He's a real Angelina Brumby.
Broby one Kenobi.
Pablo Picasso?
Oh, Professor X? Oh, wait. Marco!
Bella!
All right. I don't mean to be a bad host, but y'all need to leave. I'm trying to figure out if our president is actually an alien overlord bent on enslaving the entire human race.
Wait, what about our car thief? Have you seen this guy in your drug travels?
Weed travels, and that looks like it was drawn by a fourth grader in a high-speed car chase. Why don't you try going onto the internet and doing some of your own, like, actual research?
Can we use your machine?
No, you can't use my machine. I'm in the middle of a live stream podcast. Why don't you go use your own computer in your own house?
So, your friend Benson. Kind of a jerk.
Yeah, he was a dick.
I wouldn't say that, he's just a little bit.
Oh, crap. I'm sorry, I really thought that was gonna work. Okay.
Here we go.
Alright, here it is.
Is this storage?
Haha, very funny. If I had known I was having company, I would have made an effort to clean up a bit.
Oh, yeah. It's really eclectic.
Thank you.
Is that people having sex?
Yeah, that's my roommates. They're right above us. I think they have the computer. I'll be right back. Jeff? Buddy? You in there? Jeff? Jennifer? I just need the computer and I'll be out of your hair. I just need the computer. Slide it under the door. I'll be out of your hair. I got important business shit to take care of. Let me be your stallion. You can see my home. I'll take you by the way, dance. You know you make me home. Water on the bed. Oh,
pervert! Get the hell off of me, you busted Annie Oakley! Or I'll tell Dad you had sex with Benson. Why wouldn't I? You fucking suck!
Noises.
Oh, yeah, everything's fine. Were you snooping through my stuff, or...?
Yes. Sorry. I just figured I am in a garage in the middle of the night with a guy I've never met, and I've watched all the Saw movies, so... What is that?
Oh, that's my smoking apparatus collection. It's taken me over 11 years to acquire. It's pretty beautiful, huh?
I wouldn't really know.
Are you telling me that you, a hip chick who writes fan fiction in a leather-bound journal that used to work at a coffee shop, has never smoked pot?
I never smoked anything, okay? I mean, I just didn't rhyme with those type of social circles, you know? Hmm. What's it like?
I'll give you a crash course.
Oh, hi there. This is a bud of marijuana. For centuries, mankind has worked to create the purest strains with the most vivid highs. Now, although they're the least complex, joints are probably the most iconic smoking method. Now, to get an even burn, you gotta break up the bud. And to do that, I like to use a grinder. Now, before I was old enough to buy blunts or papers, I was using a couple low-tech methods. Apples are a tasty way to smoke, but it could be awkward. As an alternative, some kids are smoking out of cans. Then we have our glassware, the cornerstone in every smoker's collection. The possibilities are endless. This includes bombs and, pipes and, bubblers.
What's a bubbler?
That's a very good question. It's a bomb pipe hybrid. It's very effective. Just don't rest it on its side. With most glass pieces, you have to work the carburetor. This little hole allows you to mix fire and oxygen to get just the perfect amount of burn. If you're looking for the biggest high-to-weed conservation ratio, the waterfall method's worth a gander. Perfect suction. Then we got our high-tech stuff, like a vaporizer. It vaporizes the pot so you're breathing pure THC. Quick high, no smoke.
Wow, you know a lot about this stuff.
So, you think you want to try some?
It's tempting, but no, I'm good.
Come on, didn't you say something about wanting to go on an adventure and try new things?
Yeah, but...
But this is your opportunity to try something new. Come on, pick a piece.
Well, the bubbler was kind of cute.
Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Just breathe in. All right, now hold in. And exhale.
Oh, man. That tastes weird.
You feeling it yet?
I heard it doesn't work the first time.
Oh, you were wrong, girl.
Bigger than you can get out ever. Stuck there for life. It's the truth. Wait, you gotta go with it. Did you see that?
This was a unique experience for Veronica, an agent of danger, a mistress of mayhem.
She's a bad bitch. You can't mess with her.
What if you
need
a blue pen?
Because
you have blue eyes.
Oh, yeah.
That is so amazing. Have you thought about being a professional? Like a professional guitar player? Had she ever been in love? This female of fanciful fiction?
Had she? We don't know. Oh, wait. I got something you're gonna flip your shit over.
Wait. You forgot about our internet research.
It's funny how it only takes one event for the world to change.
Pearl Harbor, the San Francisco earthquake, and the canceling of SpongeBob SquarePants instantly altered the course of human history. This may sound disastrous, but as we saw with Oliver and Megan, the greatest adversities can lead to new opportunities.
Morning. You sleep like a bear. I don't mean a hibernating one. You make all sorts of crazy growling noises.
What happened last night?
We climbed the Himalayas, made out, watched Donald Duck and Mathland. Oh, you drew this picture of us. You did most of the work, but I did sharpie on the boobies.
How about John G. raped and murdered my wife on my chest?
That was me. I really like the movie Memento, but it was really hard to write backwards, so I just went for like a really standard variation.
Okay, where are my clothes, and why does it smell weird over here?
You decided to take all your clothes off and rub Icy Hot all over your body. You passed out shortly thereafter.
Oh, my God. Did we have sex?
No. Wait. Was that an option?
Remind me to never smoke weed ever again.
Noted. But, check this out. I went on the interwebs, and I typed in all-seeing eye tats Oxnard into Google, and I found this chick. Apparently, she just tattooed some dude with the same skin art Choco Taco and Baby D were talking about.
Is there any contact info?
Yes.
Wake up, Oliver!
Champ, what the hell? My eyes haven't even adjusted to the light yet.
I'm going to talk to you about last night. I did not handle that situation in an appropriate fashion.
I know. It was, you know...
Oh. Who's that?
I'm Megan.
It's Megan.
What's up? Wow, I didn't know you had a lady here. Okay. That's cool.
Did you guys, fix the nuts last night?
No, Jeff. We just met.
Well, sometimes that's the way it works out.
Jeff?
Yeah?
What the shit? Let's go! And why do those Mexicans park their fucking ice cream truck out there?
Honey, please. They're Native Americans.
Whatever.
No.
You.
She is really pissed that you screwed up our special evening last night. And by her being pissed at you... You realize that's her being pissed at me, right?
Look, you got stuff to do with the devil. I got stuff to do with the car. Let's just talk later, okay?
Megan? If you want some time, I mean, my girlfriend's pretty much the same age as you, so maybe we could all get together. Kick it.
Okay.
Sound kind of non-committal, but whatever. All right. Are you kidding me? You can't wait?
I don't wait for no man, bitch!
I've been eating donuts since I was a child.
I'm still in front of your house right now.
All right, you ready? Let's go.
Thanks.
You okay?
Yeah, no, I'm good.
This is about last night, isn't it?
No. This is about my ex-boyfriend. He keeps calling, and apparently last night he camped outside my apartment.
That dude is super intense.
It's so funny, I have all these friends that are getting married and having babies, but I was with Billy for 7 years, and I just never thought I would settle down with him. Should have broken up with him a long time ago. This whole thing's pretty much my fault.
Hey, screw that guy. I mean, at least you broke it off before it was too late. I mean, imagine making that decision after you had a mini Megan, like my parents.
You know what, Oliver? You're not nearly as much of a screw up as you pretend to be.
Thanks.
Donut? Oh, that's my favorite. Oh, all right, you can have it.
I met Oliver called a hooker after he stopped working on out last night.
Oh, I don't think so. She didn't look like a pro to me.
What? Are you kidding? Did you see that tattoo on her chest? What's that, hair? Yeah.
Well, she just woke up. Now, Oliver said he didn't sleep with her.
Of course he didn't.
That kid's a pussy. You know... I don't appreciate you saying that. I mean, he's a good kid. He's just a little lost right now.
You know what? You're right. I'm sorry. I just think that we need to do as we agreed, you know? Help Oliver get on his feet. And Tucson's a great place for him to spread his wings. And once he's moved out, you and I can have the house to ourselves. And I can take my modeling career to the next level. Can you squirt me on my stomach, baby? Oh, Jeff, what the fuck? It's always so much. Oh, all that dairy and donuts make me sick. You want this?
Definitely.
store bought said she worked at the tattoo shop on Thompson.
So she works right there?
Bingo.
And what was her name?
Crystal.
Yo, what up, Liam? We're looking for Crystal. She in today?
Got an appointment?
No, we don't have an appointment per se. We were hoping for a consultation type thing.
Yeah, we wanted to talk to her about our clientele.
What the fuck are you talking about, man? Ain't you ever heard of client-artist confidentiality?
No, I'm sorry. Can I use your restroom?
Restrooms are for paying customers only.
Yeah, I'm not really ready to settle on a tattoo just yet. Can I use it anyway?
Oh, please? I got to work on my last two fucking nerves. Crystal! Hey!
Piercing right now. Can it wait?
Well, if you want rainbow bright here to throw them all over your lot, then hell yeah, I guess it can.
Fine. Send her back.
So, E-Smoke. Is that your Christian name?
It's because I smoke electronic cigarettes, bitch.
Ooh, that's smooth.
Occupied.
Hell
no,
I'm
gonna
get out of here.
It's kind of an emergency. Oh, this is an emergency? So did Crystal
do that tattoo on your neck?
The all-seeing eye? Why are you asking so many questions?
Because you're a cop.
Fuck the police.
A cop be carrying this gun. Bag of stems. Lion blood. I used to smoke this shit back in the 90s. Thanks.
Oh, what the fuck?
God damn, your girl in here vomiting this shit? Oh, shit, sprinkle.
Now, E-Smoke. Make someone home.
They want our gold. They want to turn us into a slave race, like we were before they ran their genetic experiments on us. They made us intelligent, Benson. Don't you see it?
Okay, I'm trying real hard to see the truth here, Mark. Question, what good is gold to a bunch of half-breed alien millionaires?
Come on, Benson. They need it to repair the atmosphere of their dying planet.
Mark, it's been great having you here this whole weekend. You've really shed some light on the topic. Thus the podcast, and I do encourage all of my listeners to do their own research to further educate themselves on the subject. Thanks again for tuning into Machine Treason, protecting mankind from the man.
Their eyes give it away. Don't trust their eyes. It's ocular deception.
Oh, Jesus, enough from Fort Worth. How you doing, lady?
Yo, B, you got that door pretty quick.
Did you miss us?
Oh, you caught me. Well, I didn't miss you. I was anxious for your arrival. What is that smell?
I had an accident. Can I borrow something to wear?
Don't you live next door?
Yeah, but then I run the risk of running into my boyfriend, Billy. He's probably camped out on my front door.
Ex-boyfriend, Billy.
He's my ex-boyfriend.
Come in. All right, what's the latest development?
Whoa, Benson. Since when were you excited to hear about our antics?
Oh, please, don't be so dramatic. Just give me the news.
All right, let me ask you one question first.
Okay.
Are you really out of that platinum blue dream, or were you holding out on me? Because I smell it in here.
Twyla, will you bring the last of that really good shit?
Benson, my friend, you lied to me.
Whoa, I did not lie to you. I got really high on this and forgot where I left it.
This stuff is potent, okay? Do you have any idea the street value of this?
No, how much is it worth? I was asking you. I actually don't know how to price it.
Okay, enough drug talk.
Whoa. Weed.
We know the name of the guy who stole the car.
Who is it?
E-Smoke.
E-Smoke? Fucking E-Smoke stole your car.
You know who that is?
Deliver to him all the time. Let me tell you something. That guy plays duty like a daddy. Mad skills.
What's duty?
God.
He plays a fish?
Call of duty.
So we know where he lives.
Yeah, of course. Strawberry creamsicle.
Can I borrow something else?
I have just the thing.
So, I was thinking that we'd start with that disaster of a garage. Maybe lay out some yoga mats, put some paint on the walls, maybe a few mirrors. Make it like a little workout room.
Sure.
And do you remember my friend Mary? Well, she makes these wine racks, and I think they would be super cute in the wine cellar.
Wait, which one is that?
The cute little redhead from yoga with herpes.
No. Which room is the wine cellar?
Well, I was thinking that we could convert your office into a wine cellar. Make it like a cool, dark cave with mood lights. I just think it's completely sad and dull as it is.
What do you say we jump in the pool?
I'm laying out.
You can't take a break from your chair for a second and jump in the pool?
I can't get my hair wet.
What are you, a chinchilla? I mean, come on, you take a shower every day. What, does your hair dodge the shower water? Come on.
Really, you're being a dick, Jeff. A huge dick. Okay? This is my money maker. Makes the money.
I just don't understand why when we're hanging out together, we can't enjoy ourselves and jump in the pool.
Oh, stress me out. You sound like my dad right now. I'm gonna go to the sauna.
Jennifer, come on.
Fuck you, Jeff. This is not what I signed up for. Fuck you, loser. You deserve your lazy ass son. I'm out of here.
Why don't you go dry off your moneymaker?
Are you sure Benson gave us the right address?
You know that man never fibs the facts. You want to hit us? This platinum blue dream puts you on a different playing field.
No, I don't think I should be fighting crime under the influence. Should we go in there guns blazing? Should we come up with a plan, you know?
You know what? You can hang back. There's nothing wrong with playing it safe.
Hey, I'm coming. Oh, God. I don't feel good about this.
Fine. Expect me and expect me to catch him off guard.
You're just gonna knock on the front door. That seems pretty stupid.
Good point. Maybe we stick around back, try to find an open window.
That's not what I meant. I meant we're trespassing now.
Driving down my street, I'm going to be both men. Get the fuck out of here. Stop fucking with my fruit trees. It's just stuff, okay? I mean, plus, the gun wasn't loaded.
You're ridiculous. You put people in danger, and then you don't take responsibility for your actions, and the worst part about it is, you don't even notice, because you're always so stoned.
Come on. I hardly ever get stoned. I have such a high tolerance, I could probably smoke like a pound and be fully functional.
Let me ask you a question, Oliver. Have you ever done anything that you haven't fucked up?
Hey, don't start criticizing me, all right? I was doing just fine until you were all like, let's go on an adventure. I'm not getting tissues. It's only ever taken one dick.
I wanted a carefree, let's sell ice cream kind of adventure. Not a put a gun to my head kind of adventure. Grow up.
Come on, Megan. You just gonna walk away?
Thank you.
pages. Looks like Olava's on his own now.
Did you see an ice cream truck?
I saw a clown who got up into an ice cream truck and fled at a fantastic rate.
Hey, you're the dream chasing fellow. How is that going for you?
Not as planned. Yeah, man. I'm sorry to hear that.
You want to have a seat? Talk about it?
You know, I understand about things not going as planned. I personally was going to be an astronaut, like my pappy. A real spaceman flying around the galaxy and shit. Which is not what I've been doing lately.
Yeah. I was supposed to be riding off into the sunset with a hot babe on a fresh scooter. I gotta tell my dad I fucked up. Then I'm off to Tucson, Arizona.
Oh, hey, man. Tucson, it's great. I think you're gonna do great in Tucson. I, personally, had a lot of success in Tucson.
If you had so much success in that shithole desert, what are you doing here collecting cans?
I'm sorry, did I say success? I meant butt sex. Success, butt sex. I had a lot of butt sex in Tucson. Regardless of that matter, do you have any weed?
Yeah, actually, I do.
Oh, wait, hold on. What was that simmering honeypot of a woman? Did you, tap that ass?
No. It was an option last night, but I...
Look, man, I generally try not to dispense advice on the couch. It's sort of a breach of protocol. But I think it could help you, so I'll make an exception. Here's some advice. One, find out what women want. Two, give it to them. Now, if you'll excuse me, it's time for me to lash off. I thought maybe you'd spring for the good stuff.
There you go.
Ah, yeah. That, my friend, is some good shit. We used to smoke dope like this back in the 80s.
Herbology has come a long way, my friend. I don't think you had anything this good back then.
Hey, I am really sorry for calling you a loser yesterday. You get your shit together. You're an affluent businessman. You're a pillar of the community. I'm pretty sure. You know what? I'm sorry. What for? I confided in your son. I called you a dick.
Dick?
I also called your girlfriend a racist. And plus, I totally ripped you off on his weed. But I promise, it'll never happen again.
Well, honesty. That's refreshing.
Speaking of your girlfriend, I totally slept with her senior year.
Ouch, bro. That one hurt. Maybe that was a little too honest.
But we had a whole thing.
Yeah, but not then.
Dad. What the hell are you doing smoking with my drug dealer?
Weed dealer.
Yo, Oliver! What's up, bro?
I am so glad to see you.
The fuck?
I see you wanted to smoke. Like, he's really baked.
Dude, sit down. Let's have a little powwow.
No thanks. I quit. Does Jennifer know you're smoking?
Jennifer doesn't know shit, dude, because I kicked her ass to the curb.
Just us now. Just us. We are the most dangerous dudes on the block, dog. Woof!
I'm not gonna do that.
Yeah. Okay, Benson, can I have my dad alone for a minute?
What is your problem? I mean, I thought you'd like this, dude.
No, I don't like this. I need you to be a dad, not a bro.
But I'm with the dangerously cool guys?
I'm 26 years old. I'm an adult. You're an adult. How do we start acting like it? A wise man once told me to never let an opportunity pass you up, because they'll eventually disappear. I got something I gotta get off my chest. It's about the car.
No, you've already said enough, my child. My boy. My son.
My blood is pumping through your motherfucking veins, yo!
I am sorry I ever called you a pussy to your face, behind your back, all of it. And I like that. But sometimes, man, you gotta bite. You gotta bark like you're gonna bite, or you just bite on it.
Just to stop while you're ahead. You're starting to sound like a no-fear t-shirt. Look, you're a good dad. And I want to spend time with you, but you need to sober up. And I got some stuff I got to take care of.
I got some things I got to take care of, too.
like these fashions, man. I don't know what I'm doing.
I need your help to bite each smoke and get what's mine.
I do deliver weed, man. It's not in my best interest to go around pissing off all my clients.
You can wear a mask and you could be my hero. You could be my JFK.
Do you have a plan?
We follow E-Smoke to wherever he's got the car, beat him up, and take it back. There's no reason to overcomplicate things. We're keeping this one simple.
So we're gonna double team E-Smoke?
No. Quadruple team E-Smoke.
Quadruple team. Who else is there?
I came in. And you never go.
Split to the left. Benton, you're with me.
Oh, but why don't we have weapons and they do?
No time.
I'm here for my car, my notebook, and my motherfucking apology. Hey, how many fucking times did I tell you to lock that gate?
I did lock it. It must have slipped open.
Now shut the fuck up. You better get the fuck up out of here before I have my boys kick your ass.
They're fucking Indian. Why does everybody...
If you shut the fuck up, he's gonna recognize your voice.
If you bring it up, probably, yeah.
Benson.
You are such a dick.
Everybody shut the fuck up.
Relax. That thing ain't loaded.
I know. He's tried it before.
Man, I done told you that car is gone.
Fuck you, dickhole. Now, for the last time, stay the fuck away from me. Stupid ass. Come on, goddamn.
Smoke!
kidding, that fucker shot me.
Yeah, well, at least it was just a graze.
Oh, fuck you, just a graze. Ow! Ow! People in the Civil War died from less, thank you very much.
What made you think it was a good idea to take down actual criminals?
I don't know. That was my first sober thought in 12 years. I'm sorry I got you tagged, man. Megan's right. I do put people in danger.
That's all right, I'll live. Maybe this, I should stop being a drug dealer. Or I should do something with my life. Put me in the history books.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Like what?
I was thinking about doing a documentary about that whole reptile subhuman theory.
Yeah, I can link it to 9/11. Maybe even the Bay of Pigs.
That makes sense. That shit adds up, right?
Oliver?
Well, I guess this is where we say farewell, my friend.
You gonna be okay?
It's just a graze, right? Yeah, no, Twyla and Susie are inside. Susie was a med school dropout, so I'll be just fine.
No, that's not gonna happen. All right, just go to her. Get out of here.
Hey. Oliver, what's your face?
Going after you, Smoke.
You went after E-Smoke? But he had the gun!
Well, he had something I needed. It was really important.
My notebook. Oliver.
This is the guy you've been ignoring my text messages over?
Billy, it's over. Leave me alone.
You're just confused right now, Max. Okay? You need to come to your senses. Was this guy got you all drugged up or something?
Drugged up? What? No. Oliver's my boyfriend.
Is your what? Well, let me tell you something right now, okay? This guy is no fucking good. All right? He's a lazy, waste of space, mouth-breathing, piece of shit, stone.
Holy shit! Nice punch.
How could you use you back at the junkyard?
Fuck Prostradamus.
I like that action.
Honestly, I thought you went home and rushed to the arms of Romeo.
Oh, no. I spent 45 minutes crying in a public bathroom. And then I smoked with an aerospace gun. And it made me realize something, Oliver. I like you.
You're
hot. You look bad on your face.
Yeah.
Breakfast?
Yeah. Donuts?
No.
Right.
Get that darn Mercury back.
He got something else, though. Something far more viable than a classic muscle car. He got the chance to seize an opportunity, go on an adventure, and find himself.
Well, that's it. That's the end of the story of Oliver. Loved.
Now, excuse me.
I have to go test out my new wheels.
Hey, yo, little homie! Hey, you think you can get me a ride to KFC? Man, I'm trying to pick up some bonus nuggets! Damn!
Hey, homies! You wanna go burn a ball?
It's a long story. The car's gone.
What?
It got stolen. I tried to go after it, and I got beat up real bad by the guys who took it. They shot Benson.
What?
I've been running with a real tough crowd lately.
Well, why did you go after it? You could have been killed.
I'm trying to take responsibility for my actions. Come here.
You are stupid.
I know.
It's a problem.
That is the dumbest thing I've ever heard.
Yes, in hindsight it was. That's why we have insurance.
Yeah, I didn't think about that at the time.
One phone call.
If I had remembered that before I committed to the adventure ice cream truck version, I would have done that instead.